Good evening. Good evening and welcome to First Presbyterian Church on the second Sunday in Lent. Maybe you didn't notice, but if not, I point out the beautiful full moon tonight, and the glory of God is seen all around us if we have eyes to see, a heart open to declare the praises of God, and ears to hear God's voice. I thank you for joining us this evening. You are in for a wonderful gift. This is the 58th series of special musical events here at the First Presbyterian Church. The series of concerts presents the message of God's great love and word through many musicians, including professional vocalists and instrumentalists, national and international organists, and skilled and dedicated volunteer singers, organists, and instrumentalists of all ages. Music truly is a gift from God to us that gives us the privilege of declaring the glory of God. We are also very pleased to welcome members of the American Guild of Organists of Southwest Jersey. Thank you for joining us this evening. I'm honored to welcome to our organ, Sven Mikkelsen. Sven is a professor and head of the organ department, church music, and early music at the Royal Danish Academy of Music in Copenhagen, Denmark. I'd ask all of you at this time to make sure that your cell phones are either turned off or silenced. We don't want anything to get in the way of enjoying this great music together. You are all welcome to a reception that will be held in the Commons lobby right after tonight's concert. There, Professor Mikkelsen has available for purchase a number of organ masterpieces that he has performed. They cost $10, and we will only accept cash this evening. They'll be available for purchase in the Commons lobby. Take note that we have a few more special events that we'll be offering to you. The next will be on Palm Sunday evening, the 2nd of April. Sunday evening at 7:30, it's a concert that features the West Jersey Chamber Orchestra and Choral Society and our own church's adult choir. So you will want to make sure that you mark that on your calendars and plan to be here. Later in the spring, on May the 7th, is our youth choir concert, the final concert of the season. Psalm 33, verses 1 to 3, is one of my favorite psalms. It begins like this. Let the godly sing for joy to the Lord. It is fitting for the pure to praise him. Praise the Lord with melodies on the lyre. Make music for him on the 10-stringed harp. Sing a new song of praise to him. Play skillfully and sing with joy. That last verse gives us great instruction on how we are to worship God. We are to sing a new song to God. Tonight we'll hear great works from the past, but we should always be inspired to sing new songs as well as relishing the old. Play skillfully. Well, you're about to hear that. We bring our best whenever and always when we worship the Lord in word or song. And finally, do it with great joy. So I invite you, even in your places, to be filled with joy as we listen, as we reflect, as we pray, as we turn our hearts and our lives and our wills and minds to the Lord our God. Will you join me in prayer? Let us pray one for another. Lord God, thank you for an opportunity to consider your greatness through music tonight. We ask your blessing and favor to rest upon your servant Sven. We pray, Lord, that you would speak through his music to us tonight. Lord, may our hearts be expanded with greater capacity to love you, to adore you, and to love our neighbors as ourselves. And Lord, we ask that our minds would be expanded as well, for you are very great and greatly to be praised. Lord, we ask your blessing and peace upon us, upon this congregation and community. And Lord, we thank you and offer these prayers in the name and for the sake of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Well, friends, enjoy the concert. There will be an intermission. I'll be back with you then.
Thank you.
Well, thank you so much, Sven. What a wonderful gift you've given to us tonight. A word of thanks and a welcome to the members of the American Guild of Organists. Thank you for your presence and your support of tonight's program. We will now receive an offering, and your generosity, the gifts you give, will be used to help offset tonight's concert. So please give, and thank you for your support. Please remain seated until the offering has been collected, and then there'll be a brief intermission. When the lights are flashed, that means get back into your pews, as we'll be ready then to begin the second half of our concert. So friends, will you pray with me as we ask God's blessing upon tonight and upon the gifts we give and the work that God has called us to do. Lord, how we thank you for this magnificent music we hear that fills our souls. Lord, may you be glorified tonight in all of our lives. Lord, may we live to glorify you and therefore to discover the pleasure that only comes when we do so. Again, we thank you for Sven, for the opportunity to listen to his gifts tonight. Bless him and his family. And now, Lord, be glorified in what we give to you, not just our gifts, but our very lives. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Friends, if you would take your seats, I believe we are ready for the second half of our concert. And by the way, I was informed that Sven's music is available in our narthex, not in Commons lobby. It will be on sale after the second half of our concert. So enjoy, and the Lord be with you.
Thank you.
Well, Sven, I think you know how we feel, and I think you get that we thank you for what you've given us tonight. Friends, it's our custom, as we would conclude our evening, to receive a benediction, a blessing to send you on into life in peace. It's our custom to join hands. If you're comfortable doing so, would you take the hand of those you're standing or sitting next to? And would you remember that you're holding a gift? And would you pray a prayer of blessing upon those next to you as well as for our friend Sven tonight? Afterwards, remember a reception in the Miller in the Commons lobby. And everything's back in the Narthex. Go back in the Narthex, get something to eat, and buy some music, and the Lord bless you. Let's pray. And now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the communion and fellowship of the Holy Spirit be yours and ours now and always. Amen.